My name is Chad Knaus. I am Vice President of Competition for Hendrick Motorsports. We are from the United States. Charlotte, North Carolina is where the home base for Hendrick Motorsports is. Today we're in Le Mans, France. So this year we've been very fortunate to have a NASCAR Gen 7 race car that we have upfitted and turned into an endurance race car. We've had the opportunity to be categorized in the innovative class for the 2023 Le Mans. It's innovative because we're going back in history. If you can look back at the 1970s when the first two NASCAR style race cars came to Le Mans and competed, we feel like this one is more in a better situation and a better opportunity to go out there and compete for the full 24 hours. We do a tremendous amount of additive manufacturing. A lot of the aero bits that you see on the car behind me, you can look at the dive planes, you can look at the mirrors, you can look at the canards, you can look at the spoiler bases. All of those were made initially from rapid prototype. So we printed all of them, used that for fit up, used a lot of the rapid prototype parts for wind tunnel testing, and even a bunch of them for on-track testing. We use FDM for some of the mounts and components on the inside of the car. If you get an opportunity, you can look inside the car and you can see like our MX-7 is mounted on an FDM mount, our PBX is on an FDM mount. There's a lot of little trinkets that we use, even all the way to where we hang the steering wheel is a plastic mount. The biggest reason we use additive manufacturing is because of the speed. It's very fast, it's very efficient. We can draw it on the computer, we can program it into the machine, and in a matter of hours we can have a part to fit and hold. Obviously, different tolerances for different materials, but at least we can get a part in our hands and the mechanics can get a look at it and see if it's going to be acceptable. Like I said, this is a one-off basically. So a lot of the composite molds that we need for the layups, we'll make those out of a printed material because they just don't need to be durable and definitely more cost efficient than making them on a mill with a piece of aluminum. Sure, we'll definitely take parts. Some of the parts that we've taken from prototype into manufacturing, we'll print them in FDM, we'll smooth them, we'll finish them, we'll part finish them, and then we'll put them straight on the race car. As far as the sport in general, I don't know what everybody else does. I know when you look up and down and you see the GT class, you see the Hyper class, a lot of these guys are big companies, Dallara, Orica, Ferrari, Chevrolet, GM. I know they do a tremendous amount of additive manufacturing just for test fit and pieces. Yeah, it's definitely a passion project. I don't think there's any racer in the world that wouldn't like to have the opportunity to come to Le Mans and compete. So we're very fortunate to be able to do this. Very proud of Hendrick Motorsports and what we've been able to bring, and look forward to going out there and racing this weekend.